Hi, I'm Rachel with Simple Slides. PowerPoint is a visual product, but if your visuals are off-centered or of different sizes, it can be distracting. Luckily, PowerPoint has a number of features that allow you to make your icons and images visually appealing. In this video, we're going to look at how to align and distribute objects. Today, we're going to look at how to align and distribute multiple objects. I have here a sample slide I took from one of Simple Slide's numerous templates called Simple. As you can see, there is a creative visual at the top composed of evenly distributed rectangular bars of varying colors. So today, we're going to recreate this slide step by step, and for that, we'll need to start by learning the basics. First, let me show you this awesome feature in the PowerPoint that lets us evenly align and distribute objects such as shapes, text, and images without the need of measuring them with an actual ruler. Here I have two square shapes. As you can see, as I place one object around different areas, dash lines appear which guides the second shape to align with the first one in different ways. Now let's say I want to place this shape beside the first one and have the third shape also align an evenly distance to the first two. All I have to do is drag the shape and let the guidelines direct me to the correct position. As you can see, the guidelines also show that the objects are evenly distanced with those distant guides between each shape. It also helps that the shapes automatically clip once you place them in their aligned positions. Now that we have the basics down pat, let's try to recreate the slide we had earlier. I've already prepared five rectangular shapes of varying lengths. The first step is to take the longest shape and place it at the top center of the slide. In order to do this, place your shape at the top and then go to Format. Click on Align and then choose the option called Align Center from the dropdown. Once the object is placed properly, we can proceed to the second rectangle. Decide how you want the distance of the rectangles and place it on the left or right of the first one. This is the distance I would like my rectangles to have. Now, all we have to do is grab the rest of the rectangles, and as you can see, once I place the third one near the first two, the guidelines click the object into place, positioning it on an even distance with the first two shapes. Now let's do the same with the fourth bar. Simply grab it and click it into place. Same goes for our fifth bar, and as you can see, the guides between the shapes show that they are all evenly distanced from each other. Now all that's left is the right part. Earlier, I could have prepared 9 rectangles instead of just 5, but let me show you a cool shortcut on how to do this. All we have to do is select these 4 rectangles by holding the Shift key and then left-clicking on each shape. Once everything is selected, right-click on one of the shapes and then choose Group Shapes. This will group these 4 shapes into one, and you can basically move them anywhere while being attached to each other. Now, let's right-click on this group of shapes, hold it and drag it right here. As you can see, a copy appears, and when I let go of the right-click, it gives me an option of either copy here, move here, or cancel. Select copy here to duplicate the group. Now we have a duplicate of the group of shapes that we had earlier. However, it's in the wrong order. To mirror this, click on the group of shapes, go to Format, and then select the Rotate tool. Once clicked, you will have various options to rotate your object with. Now let's select Flip Horizontal from the dropdown. There you have it, perfectly mirrored to the first group. Now all that's left is to make sure that they are evenly distant. To do that, just reposition the group until you see the guidelines between the shapes show that everything is evenly spaced. And there you have it, a recreation of the visual from the slide we got from Simple Slides. This is just the basics of aligning and distributing shapes, and there are multiple ways you can position them to create multiple possibilities. As you can see here on this slide's template, we can create a lot of cool stuff with this principle of positioning shapes, text, and even images. Thanks to XXEyes for this tutorial. His personal YouTube is linked below for more awesome PowerPoint videos.